Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Cardiff Arms Park, home of this year's rejigged Under-20 Six Nations, and the focus for us over the next couple of hours as the countrymen of these parts, Wales, take on the tournament favourites, Ireland. It promises to be quite the matchup. Of course, earlier on today we were able to enjoy a couple of other games. Most recently, the French just managing to hold on against Italy. A few clouds overhead, but we are expecting it to remain dry. There's the results earlier on. England running out, convincing winners against Scotland at 31 points to 12. Italy, they had plenty of chances to score in that game, but they just weren't able to get away past France. But this is our focus, our 8 o'clock kickoff, Wales against Ireland. The last game of the day, but it was Ireland who, sat at the top after round one, scoring 6 tries against Scotland. Wales picking up a round one win against Italy. The Irish who were in fine fettle when the Under-20 Six Nations was truncated pre-pandemic. Feels like about 7 years ago, but they'll hope to kick on from last week. But Wales will be up for this. Head coach Johan Cunningham saying that keeping a lid on the energy is more the issue. Man with plenty of energy, he'll know what that feels like. Former England Sevens captain and lead centre who's alongside me for this one, Rob Vickerman. How are you, Rob?
Yeah, very good, thank you, Nick. Looking forward to this one. Should be an absolute cracker. The Welsh side, they have to be at their very best to take down this Irish team. As you rightly say, favourites for this tournament, so an intriguing battle ahead.
Both teams will take a moment, as we all will, to reinforce the fact that there's no place for racism in rugby, in sport, or in life. So, time for the formalities, 2 anthems to enjoy.
Thank you.
is on the back of the neck, standing up. Not even Welsh, Rob Vickerman. My goodness.
Best two anthems, those, aren't they? Fantastic to see the passion on show.
All right, let's look at the Wales team then. Johan Cunningham has named an unchanged starting 15 for this one, following Wales' 25-8 victory against Italy in round one. Openside Harry Deaves earned the man of the match nod last week, and he takes his place again alongside captain Alex Mann in the back row and the powerful Carwin Tuipulotu. With several debuts under the belt last week across the side, expect even greater emphasis on the game management from fly half Sam Costolo, who'll work in tandem with Scarlett's teammate and scrum half Harry Williams. Joe Hawkins is the cool, experienced head at 12. For Ireland, Richie Murphy makes six personnel changes to round two after their win over Scotland. Alex Kendallen once again captains the side from the back row. Up front, Jack Boyle and Mark Donnelly are promoted from the bench, while Alex Soroka moves from the back row to join Sheridan at lock, Donica Byrne in at six. Out wide, Chris Cosgrave gets a start on the left wing, while it's a new halfback pairing as Ulster's Nathan Doak comes in at nine, alongside Leinster's Tim Corkery at 10. The all-Connacht midfield of Ford and Jennings remains unchanged. On 11 replacements, only eight will be allowed to be used. Look out for Chris Chinza, who is a fresh face for Wales and Ireland, with five new names among those warming the bench. A referee for this one hails from France. Tour Trainini. He'll be assisted by Neil Chivers and Paul Dix. Also be assisted by the Scouser in the box, Ian Tempest. They've got a few boys, the big boys, the Irish, haven't they, Rob?
Yeah, looking across, they're massive. The stats and bios always have to be a little bit lenient, around about 15% exaggeration usually, but a lot of them in the back specifically, above 6'3", so aerial battle, no doubt, going to be testing this man in charge.
Well, it's Wales who get round two of the under-26 nations. Going under their campaign. The sunshine's just arrived to cast a few little long shadows across. It's been relatively cloudy most of the day.
Backwards, play on.
Pressure coming from Alex Mann, the skipper, trying to fly up.
Use.
It's Corkery who's had to go in there and try and help out Mark Donnelly, the Gary Owen
push
man.
Push back, Red.
Promoted off the bench to start Red, ahead back. Of Illo.
Use.
Mann's trying to go again, but Doak will send it down that channel. And it's Tuipulotu, who was arriving well. Absolutely monstered the schoolboy scene, and I think that gives you a little indication of why. Quick ball for Williams. Oh, they're looking to try and find it into the wide channels. Wasn't great conditions for
Remain
the first
onside.
Round
Remain onside.
Last weekend, and we've certainly talked about the fact that they want to try and use a bit more width, get it more into the
Play
hands
on.
Of the back
turn
three
over.
Wales this week.
Release.
But if Ireland managed to turn this over, and I think it was a momentary turnover, then holding onto it on the floor,
turn
and
over.
Wales have the penalty.
Right on the ground, you must
just leave. Shows how hotly contested it's going to be at the breakdown. As you always expect between these two teams, and a few specialists amongst the ranks, we're going to see them in action throughout the day. Both back rows going really well last week, very confrontational. Tuipulotu already, we're seeing just how imposing he can be from those carries. It's hard to believe he's so young, the mass that he's accrued over the years. And you're going to see a lot of these chop tackles coming in, which is good, nice and low, and that's where the contest can then happen. Straight over the ball, scorer, big number four, playing back row last week, so he's going to be loving the challenge he'll have in the row.
It's with Ethan Daniel.
Back here.
It's a penalty to Ireland.
Lifters in front. Two lifters in front.
Yeah, the referee saying that the lifters were getting in front of the man, so Wales spurning their first chance of attacking the Irish 22.
Well, there would have been countless conversations this week in the Welsh camp about discipline. More penalties last week than I've seen in any game ever. It was 22 in the first half alone against Italy, so the Welsh would be very much aware of what that then means if it becomes stop-start. They're best with the flowing rugby, and seemingly have said all week about not wanting to give Ireland the ball, because if they get possession, they keep it very well. So that ill-disciplined early doors they'll be wishing to try and eradicate from this game.
Because Wales were under an awful lot of pressure from Italy in the opening periods of last week. It was an element of managing to keep Italy out that Johan Cunningham felt really built the confidence in the side. But this is the centre pair, Carl Ford. Now they're going to put a little bit more width on it, and it's Jennings and Osborne joining the line. But Ford was momentarily knocked on, no advantage, so it will be the Welsh scrum. But you could just see the likes of Carl Ford being brought onto the ball. Jennings not quite alongside him, he came for the second phase.
Well, said about Ireland being really good at keeping hold of the ball, disproved that theory, getting rid of it after just two phases, hitting the touchline rather than the man. You can see the hands trying to create the space, but with the fullback being in the line, no space out there. And then when you make six changes in a team a week after their first hit out in 16 months, it's going to be rusty. And certainly when you change your halfbacks amongst those as well, very difficult for them to try and get hold of the game early. But you'd expect better from Ireland there.
Harry Williams turned 18 in April.
Touch!
Wales scrum half, highly rated at the Scarlets. Ewan Cunningham enjoyed how much he was barking at his forwards as he made his under-20s debut last week. He needs to just duck in to try and get this one out. It's a good line from Joe Hawkins, really experienced and calm voice in the side. Seems a little wise beyond his years, this Hawkins. It's there for Williams, he's got some work to do to get that out. Carry was from Phillips, but Irish defence did well to drive him more laterally than forwards. Another big hit in there from Harry Sheridan.
Use!
Now Williams will look aerially. Jennings is waiting to put the pressure on, but this is coming down for Osborne. And he'll look for Doak, but didn't quite make the yards that he was threatening to.
Okay, here.
Soroka, then Kendallen.
Number two, not running away.
And the referee pretty hot there. On Ethan Daniel, not rolling away. And again, discipline just beginning to creep in.
Well, if anybody's watched any of the Six Nations Championship, the under-20s programme, they'll realise the referees are very strict and are imposing themselves early in the game. That's where you've got to try and work it out. Ask the questions, what are they expecting? What are you getting away with? You know, where's that line that they create? You have to stay just the right side of it. Twice now we've seen Wales go over that line and, again, giving a pretty cheap possession to an Irish team who want to get their forwards into it. And this is the outcome. Big collisions, you see, going to combination of the 7 and 8, two of the standout players for the Welsh. Deaves with the scrum out on, keep an eye on him. Very talented player. Industrious around the breakdown. But now it's the big Irish pack managing to get hold of it.
Loughnan looks to go to the tail, nicely taken down by Sheridan, and now here come Ireland. Hit was in, but it's going to be Ford who manages to get into the 22, and then it's for Jennings. Housemates, the pair of them, both doing the job for Ireland, and then it was a little lower one for Oisin McCormack to try and take, but then Wales getting themselves in a good position, and look what that means to Carwin to a Pilotti. Like a jack-in-the-box.
It'd be some box to get him in it, wouldn't it? He's absolutely massive. But that's the man I like to see. Very much the other side of the spectrum. An open side in the modern day. 5'11", 90 kilograms. Not the usual, if you like, but that's great to say because we want to say how skillful he is. He's a real jack of all trades. He can do anything out wide. He can kick a ball, he can catch, he can pass, but this is his default. Waits for the tackle to be made. Gets over the top of two defenders, and he's such a pest. Manages to get away with it, perhaps fortuitously, but he will take that.
Must be his bedtime soon. He's regularly up at about 5:30, doing a bit of roofing for a mate of his, is Harry Deaves. He's in there again, having to make another tackle, then get back to his feet, trying to put the pressure on Loughnan, who was running forward for Ireland, but now it's with Ford, then Jennings, wanting to try and get on the outside. The tackle was good from Hawkins. Ireland trying to drive out and get quicker ball for Doak, then it's there for Boyle. Under-20's debut last week, gets the start this week, does Boyle. Doak's tried to go around the corner. Ethan Daniel, Cardiff Academy since he was 16, equal to the tackle. They're still having a scrap off the ball, the two of them. Doak not able to get there and play it away, so Corkery will have to do the other half-back role. Now Doak can play it away. Williams may have flown out of the line there. Osborne joining the line as he is wont to do. Did it plenty of times last week against Scotland as they tried to unpick them.
Advantage knock on.
Is that a knock on that may lead to anything more? Just playing the knock-on at the minute. Doak. Oh, and he's decided to go down the blind side. Ford was ready for it. Crashing towards the try line. 4 metres out now. And it's a penalty to Ireland. It's gone against Jacob Beetham.
Well, I think it's a moral outcome that they do get the penalty 5 metres out, because there's a couple of speculative actions there from the Welsh. First and foremost, you're right, Nick, called it. Harry Williams having an absolute shot out the block, trying to gamble intelligently as a spare defender, but he was a mile offside. And then, for me, that wasn't a successful catch. Therefore, you'd be looking at a penalty for the defence. But either way, they've got it. And now big decisions about what you want to do with the forwards.
Your decision, please. Okay, thank you.
Here's the play on the blind side. Nice bit of running from forward, being physical as he's always going to be. You know you've got the pack for it. The forwards will be screaming wanting the line out. And a bit of debate going on as to if you're going to take the three.
Well, Candelan has already pointed into the corner, advised the referee that that's likely to be the decision they're going to make.
8 minutes, five penalties. Three against you, two against us.
Well, there we are. 8 minutes, five penalties. The referee is all over the stats, Rob Vickerman. And there will be a sense that things are happening again on the wrong side of the whistle for Wales.
Well, we've got four downs, who's ahead of us?
Some remark, Captain. 8 minutes, five PKs, two against you, and many people chatting.
Okay,
calm down. Thank you.
It's a real conversation that was had last week about this emotion the players have got. 16 months been out of a game at this age, really is sacrilege, isn't it? And
can
you can see that enthusiasm and sometimes perhaps emotion getting too involved with it.
It's also the fact, you know, they've got five games in 24 days now. I know that that Carl Ford has spoken about relishing that, but you're right. It's all about controlling the energy.
And domestic referees, largely, from what they're used to. This is international panel last week. You know, facing the Georgian, now French referee, very different interpretations from their exposure.
So Ireland, real opportunity here. Dominating the 2020 Six Nations, but that looks like it may have been won by Wales. Can they bring it down on their side?
Push back, push back.
Oh, it looks like it's there for Williams. It's a brilliant steal at a crucial moment. And he'll make a safe clearance. Ireland will have the line out, but that is a psychological win for the home side.
It's a win, but I'll not be happy with that. Williams on an incredible apprenticeship, almost 5-year contract from the age of 16 with the Scarlets. You want to get further downfield than that. It's only 10 metres further than where the initial lineout was, so
number
a bit
two
to be worked on.
Two
and still chance for this Irish team to get their big forwards into playing with these great little lineout sets you've got. See the two pods, front and back, plenty of options.
Six, play on.
In the middle with Kendlin about to step in as well.
Good leap. Ireland try to
engage
it.
First man collapsed, play on.
But referee's happy enough that Wales managed to bring that down at source. Played away from Loughnan, on to Sheridan.
Tackle, run away, perfect, push back.
Doak has Boyle running around the corner. Oh, and he's unceremoniously dunked. Away from Doak once more. This is Donica Byrne into the starting 15. Ireland recycling well. Doak decides to try and have a go. He was met by Deeves, but they are inches away. Ireland could have numbers right if they wanted to go through the hands. It's all a bit messy. The forwards fancy trying to smuggle it through.
Well done.
Referee's gone with the held up call.
Well, it was a good recovery from the Welsh defence. Initially, a couple of inroads. That one on the ball there, Deeks, just got bounced off a little bit. And it's always a caution when you are with one of the smaller open sides that it can be pinned against you about a size matter. Don't think it was necessarily. His intent's there to hit. He's got to make sure that initial collision is positive, and there it was just too passive. And as soon as you get inroads, been a big Irish pack 5 metres from the line, that momentum's going to come at you like a landslide.
And play rugby, please.
There's a statement from the referee. Stop talking and play rugby.
Is he talking to you?
Probably.
Third and final game of the day at Cardiff Arms Park. Round two.
Set.
Of the Under-26 Nations Championship. It's there for Doak. It's waiting for Kendallan to try and pick. Kendallan's going to go round the blind side. Tries to bounce his way through. Costello was a bit more
red
of a road bump.
Six red offside.
There's a penalty coming against Alex Mann. Can Ireland turn it into 5 points? Loughnan. Doak asking questions as to where the ball is. They have got the advantage, but
here on number six, offside.
Are they going to take it quickly?
On the line.
Well, they're certainly not getting the memo about the penalties.
You're not the captain, thank you.
I'm loving this referee so far. Soroka comes over to have a word. You're not the captain, thank you. Kandelan seems to be ready to tap and go here. The Welsh repel at the first instance, but they try to go round the side here. Are they over? Referee says held up once more.
And it's a real underestimated skill, this, Nick, and I think the way the game's going is going to reward the defender much more. A lot of trials happening in the Southern Hemisphere about that now being essentially a goal line dropout, which I think is great because it's such a skill to get underneath the defender. You've got three or four players barreling in. Initial break was fantastic from Kandelan. He's so strong, isn't he? Teammates join him, but because of the melee, he can't get it down.
So just explain that a little more, the suggestion that if you've held up on your own line, that actually you get the chance to drop it out from your 22.
Yeah, because rewarding that as a defender, you've just done incredibly well. 12. What's an outcome? It's a 5 metre scrum midfield against you. That's not much of a reward. So very much trying to suggest that a drop out from your own goal line can at least give you more clearance of 20, 30, perhaps 50 metres. Still attacking ball likely, but just more of a fair outcome.
I guess it also suggests that for the team that are trying to bludgeon their way over, they've got to be pretty sure they're going to get the ball down. Otherwise, they might have to come back again from 60 metres away.
Yeah, it's exactly that. You know, you've got to compliment Wales' defence. Look at those statistics. Incredible, 92% in the Welsh half, and specifically 41% in their own territory. So that's what we're saying about recognising the defence, and why not reward them for it? You know, you've got to choose your knockout punch wisely when you're that close to the line. At times, teams probably don't work hard enough at that.
Crouch! Bind! Set!
Ireland with Osborne directly behind the scrum. They've got Ben Moxham over on the right wing. Doak looks to be feeding it to Ford, who's going route one and over the line. Try scored for Carl Ford. Ireland with the first five-pointer. And it was route one from the inside centre.
We've said about how direct he is whenever he gets the ball, and that is exactly what you want from your 12. Look at the setup. Short formation, he's already edging in front of the 10. He runs that short line, and because of the angle, he can get right at the outside of Deves, on the inside of Williams. And there is no stopping that. Costello knows it's coming as a 10, but he's in no man's land. All he needs is that half tackle. And he gets two of them. That is fantastic line from the inside centre.
Conversions added. Ireland leading by 7 points to nil. As Rob Vickerman says, after that concerted period in the 22.
That is brilliant, isn't it? All these fancy moves you can do out wide. It just comes down to a very direct arrow line back at the ball from Ford that gets the celebrations.
Kandelan. Was he slightly taken in the air there?
Remain onside,
Michael Doak. Stronghart follows the ball, then Corkery, then Jennings finding a little gap. Deves wanting to try and get the penalty, but our referee now.
Captain Red, please.
He's not too happy with all the penalties he's seeing. Let's have a listen.
It's a 50 penalty against you on this one. Your player is attacking the ground and then attacking the ball. I ask for more clear pictures at the breakdown, so please ask your player to do so. Yeah, the player, the last one, attacking the ground and then contesting the ball.
Is someone feeding him these numbers? Because he's so accurate with them. That is now 5 penalties against the Welsh. How impressive is English as well? Got to say that. Trainini.
Yeah, really clear comms from our French referee, supported by an English team from the RFU, but he's pretty clear. And this is the moment where I think it's six. Players going beyond the ball first, he said.
Yeah, the cue is if the hands hit the ground, that's what he's looking for, very clear. Yeah. He's really sharp on it as well, because you'd think that was actually okay, but you know, you need to be adjusting to that as players and just not going for as many contests, let the ball be played.
Soroka brings it down. There for Corkery, flatter ball for Ford. barring all the tackling skills of Kosolo, who he's running at so far. Another good leg drive from Harry Sheridan.
No, you are holding him. You are holding him. His ball is low because of you. But
referee alert to the fact that Ireland were the ones that were pinning it in. Soroka then scored the first try of the championship last week. Boyle into the squad with Lassisi not featuring. Got a couple of good turnovers when he came on. Loose head, trying to find a little bit more width on it, but Chris Cosgrave was well spotted and wrapped up. And if that will be the penalty to Wales. There was an extra roll by the little man, trying to protect the ball.
Extra roll, number
referee
15,
right on top of
11,
it.
Sorry.
Oh, I'll tell you what, there are some massive collisions going on at this breakdown. Deves found himself on a very heavy hit. He's not quite right in the middle of the field. You see how low the Irish are coming in. It's wonderful technique. There's going to be no discretion in what they're doing. It's very aggressive, but it's accurate. Anytime they're getting it, they're not just winning these initial collisions going forward, but it's the way they're getting cleared out. Look at that, right underneath the contact. And it means it's fast ball. That's what this Irish team want.
Bit of attention for Nathan Evans. Second year with Cardiff Blues. He'll be hoping he hasn't got an arm injury. Apparently he's one of the useful ones with the table tennis bat. Since they've been obviously having to entertain themselves in lockdown. It's one of the things Johan Cunningham has talked about. Having to keep the boys entertained. The days are filled with plenty, but there's a lot of energy in the group after that long period of prep leading up to that first game against Italy.
Lots of use of those shoulders. Massive tackle statistics in this game already. 54 for the Welsh.
Goodness me.
Time's back on.
Deves already up to double figures.
Yeah, Alex Mann as well with 9. Wales, they don't quite get the set piece right.
Play on.
Ireland will tidy up the spoils. Doak, really intelligent kick over the top. Where's that going to skip to? Oh, it's a superb kick from the Irish 9.
Absolutely fantastic. A lot of intel coming in from many, many Irish supporters about how impressive Doak is. They expect him to be taken over Cooney in the next couple of years. Really pushing for that Ulster number one slot. Might be a recognisable name to some with his dad, Neil, playing. But that is fantastic. Finds the space. And as you get on this type of surface, it's a really low run. So normally you get a spike bounce. You don't get that on rubber crumb. It just keeps on going. Revolutions fly.
Fair contest in the air. Play on.
Wales do well to win it. But Soroka doing all the leg drive work. Williams wants a bit of protection, but he also might consider putting it out into that channel where he gets the help.
Push back.
Garen Phillips. Tui Pilotti was also
onside
there waiting for it.
Use!
Williams sticks it in the air. Deves is getting under it.
Play advantage, knock on.
Came forwards off a red hand.
Knock on red, play on.
Kendallon. Little dummy, and then the straight. He's looking for the one-armed offload. Wasn't quite anybody there.
Advantage over for knock-on.
Corkery. Jennings. Just wasn't the easiest of passes, and that was just slightly nudged by Ben Moxham. So, advantage over from the previous knock-on. Wales will have a scrum here, but they're just not getting any continuity of possession at the minute, Wales. Really haven't had much of a chance to assert themselves in the game.
And it's also quite frightening how good these Irish backs look when they got ball in hand. You do not want to be giving them possession out wide.
Red,
massive players. Jennings, 6-3, as we're saying. But also, like some Moxon there, ball in hand. You just want to see him go. Could be a nervous weekend for Welsh supporters in both forms of rugby and football, Nick. Excitement building around Cardiff about tomorrow as well.
Crouch!
It's all happening, isn't it?
Bind! Set!
In from Williams. Players were running as fast as they could, but timing of it wasn't great.
Back here, green offside.
Williams wants to quickly tap. He nearly lost the ball. Was Harry Sheridan back? He was certainly continuing to retire. Referee seems happy enough. Williams, a little bit of front football for Wales. It's a little static. And it came for Joe Paird. Beacon running onto it.
Oh, oh.
Tui Pilotu.
Okay, play
Wales have gone backwards in possession here. Deves was just loitering out in that wider channel. Ireland have done really well.
Captain, please.
Now I think Kendallon is going to be having had a word with.
Some remark, mini infringement. So last 2-1 are because you are offside.
Okay.
Okay, so please ask your player to remain offside.
He's liking a regular conversation, isn't he?
I think they call it a dialogue, don't they? That continual dialogue. But you're right. There's a lot of it, a lot of talking. And clearly now both teams being warned, the next one will be a yellow card. It's been a bit of a theme of the tournament thus far. But Sheridan was most definitely not 10 metres. He was about 3. How sharp does Williams look when he taps and goes?
Thank you.
Almost too sharp. He nearly lost the ball.
Trying to find a bit of space out wide, but you can see it's really clever defence. As Doak, as the floating defender on the right, joins the line and shuts down that opportunity. This guy last week kicked mesmerically. Costello absolutely bangs him.
Well, that's your fault, Rob Vickerman.
Well, he did bang it.
He banged the right hand upright, unfortunately. That was the problem.
Oh, pinged it. Yeah, he pinged it. But the way he kicks it, it just flies. It's fantastic technique.
18 points last week against Italy, Sam Costello, but yet to open his account.
Sorry, Sam. Publicly, sorry.
Corkery. Go over to the left side. Into the hands of Beetham. Looking down this channel once more. Over towards Carrick McDonough. Williams. The Irish comes flying up. Dafydd Jenkins doing the carrying work. Costello, a little bit more depth on it. Hawkins then also able to put a bit of toe on the ball. Hawkery, oh, lovely bit of footwork to get around the first tackle.
Yes! No!
Got past Beetham. Ireland have got possession once more. Wonder whether it was the right error on the part for Hawkins to have put that little chip through. Maybe needed to push it further into the corner, but Osborne's given them a little get-out-of-jail-free card. Perhaps just took his eye off the ball with Deves in his sights. Scrum Wales.
Well, the highlight of Headguard flying toward him, undoubtedly getting in his eye line.
To my view, he is trying to compete to the ball. And because your clean out is good, play on.
It's just frustrating when these errors happen, isn't it? Everything set, line runners off him. He'd be disappointed with that. Standout player last week, Osborne. Really gifted player. Looks like a back rower.
There are a fair amount of the Irish backs that that look like back rowers, aren't there?
It's a lot of possession for them as well. Not quite turning that into points, which would be frustrating them. But in a game like this, you really have to build. And as we saw in the last round, fatigue's going to be a factor. They're going to be tired in the latter stage of this game.
It's worth mentioning, we have, might seem a slightly curious number, we have 120 fans allowed in. They've not had fans in stadia. And we have 120 in, which is basically an allocation of a couple of tickets per player. That's how that's been worked out. So we've basically got a fair few parents in the crowd.
Yeah, saw Stuart Lancaster earlier on supporting his son Dan, a bit of an Irish link to that one. We'll be watching many of the young Leinster players now, no doubt.
Yeah, Jamie Osborne, of course, who's made 6 Leinster appearances, the Irish fullback who
crouch.
Just made the unforced error, you might say.
Bind! Sit!
Williams. Way to the right.
Stop, Red! Stop! Stop!
Kevin,
stop! Thanks.
Referee screaming about the players who need to be onside. Jennings will field it onto Osborne. Steps around the first tackle of Johan Evans. And Osborne is still going, the rangy runner that he is. The Irish fullback does well up to the 10-metre line. Then Kendallon. Oh, look, a little bit of football from the number eight. And Wales lose the ball forwards from Beetham, who came forward to get hold of it.
Yeah, ball ripped and line out
as the ball was ripped. Paul Dix just checking in with him.
I'm all for the exploratory, trying to probe the ball underneath and play a bit of territory there, but just want to see Ireland keep hold of the ball a bit more. They're an out-and-out possession-based team. They build phases. They've got big line runners. Kendlin, as talented he is, didn't necessarily need to poke that one through. The cover was there in the backfield, and it's given the ball away. It's a good skill set, though. Bouncing out, Osborne beating the ever-normally reliant Deeds.
That's once.
Williams. Got a bit of a spiral on that down the middle. Is he taken in by Moxham? As he's got options on Osborne on the outside, just decides to ride the contact. Wales try and get in to turn it over, but Doak will look for Loughnan. Tackle came in from Dafydd Jenkins, putting himself about a bit. Debut last week, the Exeter Chiefs Academy man.
Push back.
Longer ball, Soroka occupying that. Look at it, ball in the right hand, and then he'll try and get the offload away. It's really nice to McCormack. Soroka, such
push
a ball
back,
player.
Push back! Play advantage offside.
Here come Ireland once more. The man taken out off the ball there as well.
Don't, very clever tactic. Offside. Williams taking out the scrum half, knowing it'd be slow ball without him there.
Corkery for Jennings. Then Ford. He just got himself back into a position to be able to come onto that ball at pace, and it was a good opportunity to give Ireland some more yards. Then it was Boyle, and then Osborne, and then picking out Cosgrave. Streaks under the posts. UCD man, starting in place of Josh O'Connor, gets Ireland's second try. And they've carved open the Welsh again.
There's a real benefit of the changes shown there when teams just don't know where he's going to pop up. Electric Cosgrave as he got the ball at that angle. Brilliant interplay again. A penalty advantage, which seems like a constant saying in this game. But because of that speed of ball, because of the options available, so many chances. There's the gap. Osborne spots it because of the defender stepping in. Costello again not able to stop him. The Irish winger finds the gap and burns through it.
Doak adds the extras. Wales 0, Ireland 14. Quarter of an hour remaining of the first half.
Really nice play, ball out the back. Nothing new, nothing different, but just those angles ran back at the ball. Make it too hard for the Welsh defenders to stop. That's what the Irish have been looking for. A little bit of possession, multi-phase play, getting those offloads going, and just big men running fast.
Lovely line from
I want
Cosgrave.
To see a clear picture while you go straight to the ball, OK? So this is why I did the game flow. Time is back on.
Questions being asked by Alex Mann as to the penalty advantage. Costello. It's a really good restart. Kendallon. There for Doak. Wales trying to drive through. They did so successfully. Doak just got the ball away in time. Then for McCormack. Now he'll take a little bit more time over the box kick clearance. McDonough isn't going to get too near this. In fact, it was Beetham, just came forwards. It's a solid clearance.
That's quality. Anywhere near the halfway line, you've done well. And he's passed it by a good 5-6 metres. Brilliant clearance from Doak. He's gone really well in this game so far.
Came through the Ulster Academy, made his senior debut earlier this year. Getting the start ahead of Conor McKee, who is on the bench.
So much noise at these lineouts. Just five man, plenty of options. Get it in.
Release, move.
Plenty of Thank pressure you. From Ireland, but it has just come back on the Welsh side. Williams.
Use.
Everyone on the same page. The back line there as flat as anything to get out of the traps after this. Oh, but it's been really nicely taken from Moxham. He beat everybody who was trying to occupy the space around him. It's a little bit loose. Then Corkery, Osborne. Looked like he might be winding up the big one, but Jennings, and then finds Cosgrave. Cosgrave puts a little left toe on it. Wales herring back, but so is Jennings. Now, can Wales play from inside their 22? Oh, lovely jinking run. Lovely footwork. Was that Dan John? There for Williams.
Use!
Super break, but...
Stop, seven
John
red.
Has done well.
Seven red!
Deeves has come
back
flying up.
Red, offside.
He was being called offside by the referee. If the Irish wanted to go quickly here, they might find...
Offside. Well, I asked you twice to stop.
It's becoming one of those players, Deeves, isn't he? Everything he wants to do is just being done on the wrong side of the law at the minute.
That's why he's wearing seven, I guess. It's one of those, you find the line very quickly as an open side. Unfortunately, couldn't quite get there. But this is a lovely break from the Irish again. Good hands, nothing too difficult. A little bit of lateral running, but it finds the space. Ball in behind. It's just an out-and-out foot race here. You get a lucky bounce off one on Rubber Crumb. And then you get to see wonderful step from John. Oh, I don't quite see it. It was bounced off the left and off he went. Thought it was going to be a worldie coming up.
Opportunity for the Irish just to keep the scoreboard ticking over. Doak. Three out of three.
There's that Cooney skill set coming through. Doak going to be pushing him hard. A lot of Ulster fans will be excited at the competition for the nine shirt this year.
Richie Murphy, key part of the Ireland senior setup since 2013, coaching the under-20s. Former assistant coach of Leinster during the glory days, winning three Heineken Cup titles, back-to-back Pro 12 titles 8 years ago now.
No, four red.
He doesn't like the look of what Joe Payard's trying to get up to. Corkery, Osborne, well, it was just a little bit too soft from Corkery, but having to be tidied up by Carl Ford. Now Cosgrave tries to put the left boot through it once more, but
back here.
It's coming back down for Ethan Daniel.
Number seven is offside. Nothing major because ball was close, so it's
familiar words again there, Nick. Seven offside.
I think it was an accidental one, wasn't it? So it's just going to be the scrum.
Just a scrum.
You run the risk if you're wearing a bright yellow scrum hat, don't you? This goes one way or the other.
Time is off.
Cross, right.
Of course, there have been a few players with colourful scrum caps over Wales this time. Justin Tipperick, another one with the bright
the last
yellow
one.
I'm going to say blue off the top of my head.
We will start with a scrum.
So, yes, bright blue, Deeves with the bright yellow.
We need to see some rainbow head guards.
You are not doing good today. Perfect.
How aggressive is your touchy play? Would you need a...
I don't think so. I don't think I could get away with a rainbow head guard. I'd be laughed out of town.
Time's back on. Scrum green.
Challenge Harry Deeves during the week, though. Plenty of people talking about him.
Scrums are good. Keep working, guys.
Watches a roofer to help out his mate. Ospreys Academy trains at 6:30. Of course, he's from Pontyclun. Says that he's a badger for life. Shout out to all of those who might be tuning in from Pontyclun.
Crouch!
He plays like a bit of a honey badger, doesn't he? Take on a python.
Bang! Set! Use!
Ford's come close to this scrum, ready to take it from Kendallen, but now they're going to play the training ground move that involves Doak, but it didn't quite find Osborne, and now Moxham. Had to try and restart the momentum. McDonough's just momentarily stayed in there and made a nuisance of him, and actually slowing that down and seeing it come back on the Welsh side, and it's to Ipolotti with the carry. May have lost it in there a little bit, but it comes back again. Jenkins was off from Paird.
Runaway tackler! Thanks!
Central position. Costello. Try and get that in behind, but...
Stop, Red! Stop!
Perhaps needed a little bit more on it. Doak was well positioned. Safe enough clearance from just inside his 22.
I do really like this halfback pairing of the Welsh. Williams is your quintessential nine, constantly being cheeky, asking those questions of the referee, pushing that line a little bit, raising that tempo. And Costello, it's a shame of this pitch, as I mentioned, is rubber crumb, because the way he kicked that ball was trying to make it bounce towards the touchline, and that's impressive stuff for the cold face from Ryan Evans, winning the ball for the Welsh, getting some rare possession in Irish territory.
Costello, Hawkins to Pilotti. Ford was straight up to shut down that midfield space. Costello a little deeper now. Joe could come up, hoping to try and disrupt, but Wales worked their way around him. But they're having to fight so hard for every inch, such is the aggressive nature of this Irish defence. Up hard again, combining Donica Byrne. Doing a job. Costello. Hawkins just trying to find a way through, twists and turns.
What is available?
Talked about the boys being a little bit too keen last week to Joe Hawkins during the week. They're having to be patient this afternoon or this evening. Costello once more. Then they try and go through Beetham.
Had to be forward that.
Costello offering himself a little deeper, but he wanted the forwards to truck this one up, but the Irish...
Runaway tackler, ball available.
...managed to stop them. It's been a couple of minutes of Welsh possession, but they've probably lost 20 metres.
Williams
decides to stick it in the air. Nicely taken from Doak. Follow-up tackle was decent enough from John, and Wales have got themselves the penalty. Now, will Williams want to go quickly on this? Given how infrequent the visits have been to the Irish 22, this needs to go into the corner.
Yeah, I think that's a good call. John was seeing him both sides of the ball. Lovely little attacking play when he was last in his own 22, and that was brilliant defence. Catch from Doak, but then, because the cleaners missed John over the ball, just all too easy. Can't complain there, it's absolutely right decision.
Looking at the action areas there, Rob Bickerman, just see a little 19% beginning to arise near this area of the field as Wales bring it down. Perhaps catch and drive time is going to be the option. The Irish equal to it to begin with, but now the Welsh get a bit of go forward, but they've had to break. Can they get the support there? Can't try and turn it over on his knees. Williams will have a look right. I think he wants to get Deaves around the corner. Pops it up. Deaves will have to get in the sidecar this time.
Push back.
Comes back for Williams. Out for Alex Mann. Jenkins was with him. Tui Pilotu is there, but it's not the tidiest of balls. It's there for Johan Evans. Wales finding a little bit more width here. Tui Pilotu over it, but Williams will fire it away. It was a really good angle on run from Garin Phillips. Just eats up another couple of key metres. Now Tui Pilotu steps back. Wants to steamroll his way through. Williams has got Costello now looking for it on the right. Oh, it was a critical juggle needed. He's had to come back against the grain. It's a penalty to Ireland. Found themselves isolated. And it's a superb turnover. It's that man, their man of the match last week, Alex Kendallen.
Three red on the side.
Well, you can see why he's got the hype. From the Munster men. What a role of honour it is seeing number eights at that club, and he is absolutely showing traits to join them. Really good defence again, this Irish team. So comfortable just absorbing these runners at the Welsh have. And you mentioned about Costello, a little bit of a juggle. That's where he had to cut back, came back in field, and because everyone was stood in front of him, the Irish then go forward. And look at the celebrations afterwards. That's how much a good defensive set means. Keeping that scoreline to nil. It gets you pumped.
Certainly done the job for Kendallen.
Okay, number 10.
Senior debut against the Scarlets in March. The Irish skipper. Played a bit of sevens as well. Continues with the start from last week, the corkball man.
We are going to restart. Just be ready.
He's coaching as well now, the ref.
Be ready for the restart. Just my information.
Just FYI.
Word for Dennis Leamy as well, who's been helping the under-20s, the former Munster Ireland back rower, with their defence. have just been driving Wales back each time they've had the ball.
Well, his stock's rising. 36 minutes of this game, and the defence is looking outstanding, led admirably by that man. Hendelin looking fantastic.
Loughnan and Boyle have a little tete-a-tete. Lad from Birr. That's where my Auntie Mary lived. Shout out to Butler's Pharmacy in Birr and everyone over there who's watching. Soroka. Then through Doak. Moxham. So Clancy's trying to work it. He wanted to try and get it back in field for Osborne.
Back on by number three.
Kendallen. Little soft pat of the ball along now then. Where's Cosgrave going to try and find a hole? He's not the widest, so we might find a little gap then. Doak, it's a little bit loose here from Ireland, but can they re-find a bit of structure? Oh, back in field, it's worked out for Moxham. Moxham now straight down the centre of the park. Cover tackle had to be good.
No!
This is Please Ireland once again knocking on the door. Away to the left they go, it's Donnelly. Another one of those who's had a bit of sevens experience, Munster A as well.
Run away, tackler!
Referee very Push hot on red. The defenders rolling away. Little show.
Release
Wondered
them.
If Harry Sheridan was just going to glide his way through for a moment there, the second row. Then it's popped up for Loughnan. Good tackle from Nathan Evans just to stop them. Now Kendallen going into Costello. Just looking to change the point of attack as Loughnan offloads to McCormick. And it's loose on the floor. Soroka trying to tidy it up, but there was already the knock-on there.
Ball goes forward.
Wales perhaps will get away with one there.
Absolutely, we celebrate the Irish defence, and rightly so, but that was a wonderful tackle from Dan John. He came in and flattered Moxham as though he was going to stride under the posts. He's taking a little bit out of these teams now. Latter stage this first half, but it's lovely play by the Irish. Low numbers, comfortable with ball in hand. There's the bounce on the inside from Moxham, and then the goose step trying to get him around. And then out of nowhere, that's the tackle. John kills that play.
Had a fair bit to travel to do so as well, didn't he?
Right on the side there. You see him on the right-hand side of the shot, Nick. He comes all the way back in field, and that's what you want from your back three. Sure is. Oh, man, I'd be proud of this one, probably watching out in Hong Kong. But that is a wonderful chop tackle. Committed, brave, and it stopped what looked like a dead cert try.
Yeah, son of former Wales scrum half Paul John, 10 catch scrum half for Wales. Dan John was also at Cardiff City Academy with Alex Mann. Pretty handy athlete as well. Well, he covered the ground there in double quick time.
Okay, at the breakdown, I see the clean out are clear at this precise moment.
Need to see
over the ball.
Whether Nathan Doak has got a bit of an issue. You can just see Ethan Lloyd. Conor McKee warming up down below us.
Cheap seats out on the balconies.
Number four, green, scrum red. And tennis back on.
Cardiff summer party in full swing.
Perfect flight for your rugby fan. You have to pay a penny.
Crouch!
Is it south facing? No, it's stadium facing. Oh, excellent.
Yeah, I think
I'll take it.
Space on that side. Please keep space. Let's go, guys.
Let's go. It's him again.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Again. Big scrum. Big scrum.
Massive scrum from the Welsh here.
Rose!
Ireland looking really stable, really strong. They'll be trying to attack this one.
Let's go, boys.
Crouch!
Sink and break!
Fine!
Minute left until the break.
Set!
To Pilotti. Costello.
Stop, Red!
Under an awful lot of pressure.
Yeah, to put on his left foot, really clever play, trying to put pressure on the fly off. You know he's got an absolute boom of a right. So try and get him on his left, stand outside of him, push him back across the breakdown. Now a bit of nonsense to follow it up.
It was all a bit, you were looking at my bird, wasn't it?
Still block him. Wait. Time's back on. When you want.
Loughlin. Ireland already. With two tries on the board. Oh, it's a penalty for Wales. Players in front of the ball.
Release eight. Thanks.
Well, you can tell they've been working on that one, Nick, just by those celebrations. Tried to spin it. Referee pinging. The Irish joined in front.
He went out. He was 2 meters away. Thank you, number eight.
Trying to have a conversation about where he's coming in from.
Yep.
Well, time in the red. A little look from Harry Williams and from Costello, and the ball will go into the stands. Wales then with perhaps plenty to ponder at the end of that first half. Two tries from Ford and from Cosgrave. 7 points from the boot of Doak as well at half-time at Cardiff Arms Park. In the under-20s round two, it's Wales nil. Ireland steady as she goes on 17.
Ben Hovran,
Moxham over on the right wing. Doak looks to be feeding it to Ford, who's going green wide and over the line. Try score for Carl Ford. Born directly behind the scrum.
Osborne Sin Hovran,
Ben Moxham over on the right wing. Doak looks to be feeding it to Ford, who's going green wide and over the line. Try score for Carl Ford.
Osborne Sin Hovran,
Ben Moxham over on the right wing. Doak looks to be feeding it to Ford, who's going green wide and over the line. Try score for
Carl
Ford.
Well, and Seath
Loud looks to be feeding it to Ford. He's going green wide and over the line. Try score for Carl Ford.
Well, and Osborne Sin Hovran.
Ben Moxham over on the right wing. Doak looks to be feeding it to Ford. He's going green wide and over the line. Try score for Carl Ford.
Well, and Seath Lawr, a canol oedd hi'n syml yn y pen draw, ond oedd e mor ff...
Ireland with Osborne directly behind the scrum.
Osborne Sin Hovran.
Ben Moxham over on the right wing. Doak looks to be feeding it to Ford, who's going green wide and over the line. Try score for Carl Ford. Ireland with Osborne directly behind the scrum.
Osborne sin hovran.
Ben Moxham over on the right wing. Don't look to be feeding into Ford. He's going rewind and over the line.
A dod neb yn mynd rwystro Ceithel Ford. Lawr y llwybr canol, maen nhw wedi bod yn bwerus y ddau ganolwr. Dyma llall.
He just got himself back into a position to be able to come onto that ball at pace, and it was a good opportunity to give Ireland some more yards.
Then
it was
Boyle,
and then Osborne, and then picking out Cosgrave. A good opportunity to give Ireland some more yards. Then it was
Boyle,
and then Osborne, and then picking out Cosgrave. He just got himself back into a position to be able to come onto that ball at pace, and it was a good opportunity to give Ireland some more yards. Then it was
Boyle,
and then Osborne, and then picking out Cosgrave. Streaks under the post. You see the man. Opportunity to give Ireland some more yards. Then it was
Boyle,
and then Osborne, and then picking out Cosgrave. Streaks under the post. Good opportunity to give Ireland some more yards. Then it was
Boyle,
and then Osborne, and then picking out Cosgrave. Streaks under the post. You see the man.
The
starting in place of Josh. A good opportunity to give Ireland some more yards. Then it was
Boyle,
and then Osborne, and then picking out Cosgrave. Streaks under the post.
You see the man.
Jennings, then Ford, he just got himself back into a position to be able to come onto that ball at pace, and it was a good opportunity to give Ireland some more yards. Then it was
Boyle,
and then Osborne, and then picking out Cosgrave. So second half about to get underway at Cardiff Arms Park. It is Wales against Ireland, the Six Nations Championship. It's round two. Wales who overcame Italy last week, Ireland who overcame Scotland. Ireland who in the 2020 truncated championship were cruising towards a potential Grand Slam, the defence of a Grand Slam no less. Arguably the favourites. Leading by 17 points to nil, then Ireland get things restarted. A few changes have been made for Wales. We'll try and identify a few of those as we go. Certainly one of those we can see on is Chris Chinzer.
Stop.
Harry Williams.
Okay.
It's like another Harry in the form of received the Shepherd's Crook at half-time. Perhaps the wrong side of the penalty count a few too many times.
Push back.
Doak with a little dink over the top. Cosgrove's getting after this, but he's not going to quite get close enough. Costello. Did well to get hold of it. Williams. Those players around the corner down the short channel. Chelsea, one of the men. Getting over it. Expected to bring a fair bit of energy to the side. Williams always lost it backwards and in trying to tie time at all. Chinzer. Matua Pilotti. Doak. Really nicely taken. Oh, and he spotted the room down the touchline. Doak swats off Harry Williams. Osborne in support. Osborne scragged. Looking at the corner. The nonchalant finish. And what a...
Well, one of the standouts from that first half has continued his performance. Nathan Doak, hotly talked about in Ireland, and rightly so. This guy has got a wonderful future ahead of him. That was poaching of the highest quality on this near side. Gets the box kick from his opposite number, then beats two easily, finds the outside, and again it's Williams covering for the cover, cannot stop him. Support from Osborne on the inside, and so casually absorbs the two defenders, gives it back to Doak. What an angle this is to witness. What he does, bounces on the inside and then collects the offload to score it.
Got 12 points now with the try and the previous kicks. This is trickiest effort to date. Oh, it's just gone outside the right hand upright. Thought it might come round. It's not what Wales wanted to see, though. Real awareness of where the majority of the Welsh defenders were as he made this run.
John initially doesn't make the tackle, nor does Williams coming across. And it's that interplay from 9 of 15, that improves the score again for Ireland.
Kendallan takes the restart. Wales 0, Ireland 22. Doak tried the little dummy at the base there. Driving round. Did the work to free his scrum. Half as Donica Byrne comes around. Nicely taken from Costello. Beetham. And big Nathan Evans made his debut last week. Tui Pilotu just got a little overran by Ethan Daniel. Williams, Costello, Hawkins. Three Irish defenders continue making the yards and present the ball back. Tui Pilotu just hasn't had the room to work in Ireland, have really shut down the Welsh eight. Now the knock on.
Play advantage, knock
back with Sheridan. Byrne will play it back. Hawkery looking to try and kick the corners, coming across is beaten. Puts it up into the air. It's an interesting call, but Doak, oh, he's absolutely munched. Timing was superb. It's come back with the Welsh. Tui Polotu. Williams.
Oh. Stop, Fred.
Good eyes up work from the Welsh fly half. Where's the ball going? Moxon under a lot of pressure. Oh, he's carried it over. West Scrum, and that might just give them a little bit of confidence.
Well, I'm not quite sure what he's thinking there. Any clearance kick would be preferred to a 5 metre scrum, but that was all about the hit.
Nathan Doak has still not got up.
Breeze, okay, take your time.
Such momentum on it, you think it might well have been the aftershock of the hit itself, where the head whacks the serve.
He's probably just trying to keep his luncheon.
He is looking at it, competition is fair, so this is why we don't have a review.
And here we go.
But he
catches it. I think he does land. We didn't see his feet, but it looked like it was well timed.
In life for me, Jan, the competition was fair.
Yeah, left foot was just on the turf as the hit came in.
He got absolutely melted. That is exactly what you want. Beetham's looking at the ball, he's looking at the man, times it, waits for it, and smashes him. Bit of claret on the back of his head as well, matching his shirt.
Okay. Played a bit of Celtic with Cardiff last season, Jacob Beetham. 2020 campaign upended when he was taking the high ball against England. Well, he's dishing it out now, isn't he?
Look at pump the pack are as well. Big noise coming in from the men up front. Yeah, Moxon putting the ball down in his sacrilege.
Got the likes of James Fender onto the field as well, who came through the ranks with South Gower and Neath for Talbot College. Swansea-born man is adding 18 stone.
Set.
In that second row, Tui Polotu at the back, trying to drive, and they are getting a little bit of go forward. You wonder whether Williams might have just waited a moment longer. Forwards could have perhaps milked a penalty, or maybe even more. Tui Polotu has Chinza looking to try and drive through.
Push back green, push back green.
Another drive from Wales, just a metre short this time.
Goes backward, play on.
Now there's room, round the corner, nobody guarding that side, and Alex Mann, the skipper, came through his hometown club, Aberdare. Well, he came out of nowhere around the corner there and got the try for Wales. They're on the board.
Well, Mann has spent the majority of this half being your absolute default number six, clocking up incredible numbers, 16 tackles, 6 carries, and how crucial is this one to get them back in the game? Very static, not going anywhere. You think initially it was great defence from the Irish. Tupelota goes without the ball, almost tactically you'd think. As three men were drawn in, and then Mann finds the space round the outside of it.
Costello fades across the front of the posts. Wales 5, Ireland 22. The home side need to get them more into this.
Well, they needed something. And the base. Tupelota drops it, rolls backwards, and absolutely right, play on. Rewind it. Think about Moxon in that corner, put it down. That was the chance this Welsh team wanted.
Absolute ton of pressure on Dartford Dan John.
Push
he did
back,
well.
Green back.
Jennings was desperate to hit the man, but he had to wait until he'd caught the ball. An unchanged starting 15 for the Welsh. Just be interesting to see what these changes now in the second half might do. Osborne quite happy where he was there, allowing that to bounce, but dummies the feed out to the right and then out to the left to hit. Osborne's feeling that a little bit. Doak probing the fringes. Can back up for Donnelly.
Release! Stand tackler, you must release.
It's another really good, quick carry from Oisin McCormack. He's been making the right choices, doing the right things at the right time, the Irish open side. And this is Soroka. Makes a decent amount of yards as well. Osborne. He almost left the ball behind. So Hawkins there.
Line out, Fred.
Seeing a little bit of swing in this momentum. Nick, you mentioned it in terms of the defending admirably, and Ireland looking a little bit more forlorn. Need to get a grip of it. So Rocket likes to get involved, doesn't he? Big number four. The young bull. On top.
He's just time off. Just taken a knee
injured
there.
Player green.
Something's just given him a bit of jip.
Say how remarkable it is that the Welsh are managing to name the same starting team as last week. Not quite the same for the Angels, but there's a man who showed perhaps the wares from last week. Could be for these men. 16 months, some of them, in between games as well.
You are not attacking the ball, you are attacking the player. This is why I can accompany you. But this is my view. Maybe Font I'm wrong,
man.
But this is
Alex Soroka. Said earlier he scored the opening try of the championship after 3 minutes against Scotland. Yeah? Second year in the made his senior debut this season against Glasgow Warriors. He was in the back row last week. Moved to the second row this week.
Green line is yours. Okay. Just hold. Wait, wait.
Hell of a specimen, isn't he?
Time is on.
I think his brother's not far off as well. Ivan playing with him in front of.
Move!
Ball taken down by Fender as the referee's mic nearly deafens us in commentary. I think he's told people in Newport that that's a
back here,
penalty. Wales
on the side.
As if they understand him in Newport.
Yeah, but the ball carrier is in front, so the first one is coming on him, so play on. And number seven coming on the side.
I don't always agree that referees have to justify themselves when players start asking the questions there, because it happened a lot last week, and it's a real underlying message of this game where there's a lot of penalties going around, and you have to just adjust rather.
Yeah, the players know the laws of the game. The coaches are there to do the coaching. It's a penalty against you, get back. Change being made for Wales. Ollie Burrows coming onto the field. Former Ospreys Academy man. Relieves Ethan Daniel. Joined Exeter from Millfield. Made his debut
on
last week.
It's a big theme, actually. Quite a few of the Welsh guys with experience with Exeter. Big weekend for them as well, but I just like the fact they go to university in Exeter, so double bubble. You get your rugby, but also get your education.
Thanks, Dad.
Alumni representative, I'll have you know.
Very good. Oh, penalty, Ireland.
Number 20.
Then jumping across in the line-out.
Two players in front.
Sort of execution inaccuracy that's just frustrating as anything.
Yeah, but for me, ball carrier is not accessible.
But again, another debate about it.
So the two players are in front.
Get on with it. I think the frustration's there clearly because, as we said, the Welsh were building that momentum, they've got the territory, they rate their line out, certainly with the units they've got, and now it's going to get pinned back slightly. Jumping across, you're saying.
Red, please.
The lifting's fine, it's just you can't then step into the channel. It's meant to be clear.
Forward. First direct run. Quick ball again. Jennings. Missed pass out. Cosgrave.
Release.
Osborne helping effect the clear out. Doak fancying another tiptoe down the whitewash. He was just in touch in possession there. But Doak. Corkery working so well at keeping that tempo up. And you've got the likes of Shane Jennings in an outside
really
channel also working with forward. You've got
maybe
some lumps light back row as we've talked about. And they're gamely making those yards for Ireland.
They call five.
He's really tiptoeing down here. Not much space at all. Teams often play to a 5 metre line to then go back infield. But there he spots a chance. It's unfortunate. Jennings hits that inside line, you got another line break.
He had to run in profile to get round. Cramp.
Tackle, release!
Tui Pilotti was trying to release this and get this back on the Welsh side. Williams wants a little bit more protection. Gets it from Fender.
No, now stop, five red, stop!
Chases on from Dan John, but he's not got anywhere near Cosgrove. Needed to watch the ball. Doak. Court line from Byrne. McCormack is there.
Use!
Costello is positioned at the back here for Wales. He's going to stay in field. Cosgrove just holds on to his coattails. Williams. Nice little bit of soft hands to ship it on from Ollie Burrows, the replacement. Give Chinzer a little chance to dart up. Those are some key yards. Could do with a little bit more of that from the Welsh side. Costello looking to try and find it in the outside channel. And oh, then it was just lost by Alex Mann. Everybody's asking questions over who that came off.
Suggested it was slapped out.
Macomb, choice green scrum.
He's giving the knock on. Mann is getting through some serious work here today. He's leading the stats, well and truly. 17 tackles, 7 carries.
Might be a little unlucky with that decision. Harry Williams leaving the field.
You're still working well at scrum, keep doing.
Guys. Ethan Lloyd.
Keep doing at scrum.
Another one of those who's been a bit handy on the ping pong table by all accounts. He's coming on. How would you rate Williams' contribution?
I think he'd be a bit frustrated with that. The box kicks were clearly a part of the game he was looking for, with a bit of shielding, but just didn't quite get those right. Led to a try. A few opportunities where the ball was given away. Just needs to perhaps work on not kicking them quite as far. Get some height on them. But when it's such a big part of your game tactically, the execution has to be there. You need to work in tandem with John. It just hasn't quite happened for him. He's an exciting player, but I think he'll be a bit frustrated after this game.
Doak. It's a really good run from Corkery. And Doak is there to play it away. Kendallan is going to be the dummy runner. Jennings will offer himself. And then Osborne, he's absolutely flung that towards Cosgrove. Bit of tidying up work. The Irish have invited themselves down where there's almost no room to work in. Tui Pilotu driving Kendallan back in the tackle. All the energy in that hit, bit of after chat as well between the two number eights. It's a fascinating contest, that one. Corkery then for Jennings, popping up on the right side.
Tackle!
Hawkins in there trying to just slow down the Irish momentum, as is Jenkins.
No hands, Red! You are fit!
Doak, Corkery, looking to put a little bit more depth on it, bringing Moxham in off the right wing. Doak has Sheridan to the left, but he's not going to use him, with the option of using more of the front row men. There's real clarity from Ireland at the minute, men knowing where they need to be and what's coming next, and coming next is Corkery and using forward.
Play offside.
Sheridan.
Number five.
It's quick ball again for Doak. Corkery senses a chance to get through. It was a brilliant last-ditch tackle from Nathan Evans, just clinging onto the boots. Here. Otherwise, the Irish fly half was possibly all the way through to the line.
And you're right, these penalties coming through from this flow the Irish have now got. Really mixed up nicely, played off 9 and 10. I think it's taken out of them as they look a little bit tired. Taking a bit of a knee around the referee as we're seeing. But just nice mixed up of play. And when you're playing off 9 and 10, defensively, it's so hard to get set because you have to adjust your width. And that's where the penalties start creeping in. Really good play from the Irish.
Time's back on, posts. Yes.
Simple bit of game management now from Ireland. Opted just to go for the 3 points from this penalty position. Take a breather, get the water on, and keep the scoreboard ticking.
I've got to say, these players have adapted really well with the changes. six for the Irish coming into this team. Can be quite disruptive. Bear in mind they've probably only had one on-field training session as a bit of a hit out after playing 7 days ago. So really is a case of trying to adjust as fast as you can.
Moments ago in your picture, saw Ethan Lloyd, 19-year-old from Cardiff Blues, making his debut. This is Doak to take Ireland to 25. Decent nudge. Wales 5, Ireland 25 now.
And as you say, it's about that game management now, Nick. These next phases of play, just trying to quell what's coming at them. Going to be some red jerseys trying to get a bit of momentum, get the ball, get into them, but the Irish have to be composed.
Time's back on.
And continue their wonderful flow this game.
Costello. Moxham. Kandelen. Penalty Wales.
First man. Kandelen. Really released, he can contest.
Took it. Found himself momentarily isolated.
Owen Evans has been brilliant over the ball. A couple of times now he's put himself in possession to try and steal it back. And that's exactly what the Welsh wanted. Talk about the Irish management. You get this restart chance. It's a good take from Kandelen. The man too static around him. Three players not able to try and get there as fast as Evans did. And there's a little wink about it. That's what you want from your leaders.
20 next month, the Pontypridd ball man. Used to play a bit of rugby league. The South Wales Rabbitohs, no less. Played a bit with Harry Deeves at under 15. Apparently they were schooling the under 17s. Well, with physicality like that, you can understand why. But this is Wales. They've been given the call to have to use it here. Ethan Lloyd is treading on dangerous water here, but now there's a penalty advantage. Wondered if the referee might award the scrum the other way, but he's now seen a penalty. So Hawkins, a little deeper. That was nice from Costello. Couldn't quite get beat them over the line. Chinza, oh, has he knocked that on? We're coming back for the penalty. And it's going to be a yellow card.
Touching, please. Dynamic situation. You're not rolling away. It's a yellow.
It's Jennings, is it?
Yeah, absolutely right. Explained brilliantly by the referee.
Dynamic situation. Number 13, not rolling away.
Because of the speed of the ball, you've got to get out of the way quickly. Jennings knew exactly what he was doing there. It's a try saver. He recognised that. But it's a wonderful bit of deceptive play. Again, Costello showing his class. Really like this guy's rugby intelligence. Number 10 for Wales. I think he's a name he's going to be mentioned many, many times in the years ahead.
Well, he's walloped that over the touchline in the corner. Wants another bit of catch and drive.
Mo!
Catch has been affected.
Red on the ground.
It was on the ground, but where is it now? It's there for Lloyd.
Back!
Ireland trying to disrupt. Tuipulotu trying to get inside Soroka. Costello, oh, they're running around the outside here now. Hawkins, the ball to the corner, the finish, the try's there. Scored by Carrick McDonough. He had a little bit of work to do, but he did just enough. And the Dragons man, 18 years of age, gets Wales' second score.
Well, he showed his pace there. The ex-Wales sprint champion needing every single metre per second to fly around the outside. Not a massive amount of space, but great interplay. This is what Wales have done all game. Tuipulotu absorbing those defenders, the quick hands in the middle, the playing behind, and the overlapping space out wide. Jutter in step, and Doak, as good as he's been in this game, was not able to stop the Welsh flyer out wide.
Love seeing that pass from Joe Hawkins as well. Under pressure, needed execution. It was just the perfect point for McDonough to run onto. All of Costello's kicks have been in fairly difficult circumstances, positions. To to try and use the pitching wedge under that one, and it's worked. Lovely effort. Wales 12, Ireland 25.
Game context all important now. That's exactly what we wanted to see from the men in red. The Irish a little bit flustered in that midfield defence. Moxham stepping in, Osborne not able to stop it. As we mentioned, Doak couldn't quite quell it.
Attempted clearance from Hawkins was successfully charged down, almost blocked entirely. So it's now with the Irish. Doak looking back towards this side. Cosgrave suddenly side pedalling out towards the touchline. Kendall.
Release! Your feet.
Chinta absolutely lined up. Sheridan there. Ford is trying to look a little bit more creatively through the gap. Jack Boyle.
Release that club.
He has been such a live wire throughout the course of this game.
No, release.
Leinster man, just 18 years of age.
You're not contesting, you're just putting your hands down and you're slowing the ball. Try to leave the ball to play on.
Referee is reading out the rule book effectively to the skipper, Alex Mann.
It all comes for these exit sets for the Welsh, not able to clear their lines effectively. Saw it a few times on this near side touchline with the box kicks. That one charged down. And as good as it was building. Chipping away at this board. The Irish now able to extend this lead. There's a few players are getting rid of the old cramp, tingling legs, no doubt, playing their part. Still got 20 minutes.
Yeah, the likes of Sam Illo, George Saunderson and Daniel Okeke are waiting to enter the fray. Three points added from Doak. Ireland determined not to be rattled by Wales getting 10 points on the board the second half.
As you said, the subs are coming on. Big lads about to enter the fray. Just one point to note is how high Costello takes these restarts. So you're just on the pitch and you may well have to be waiting for a 3.5 second restart to land on your head.
Just extolling the virtues of Boyle, and he will be relieved of his duties. Him and Donnelly have put in a really good shift.
Push back, Red! Back! Use!
Sam Illo just to the right of the ruck. One of the try scorers last week.
By advantage, knock on Red.
Beat them. Seemed to arrive at just the right moment.
Sorry.
But I think
first
in the,
red,
in the collision,
second green, scrum
just
green.
Lost it forwards.
Thanks, Paul.
Just clapped his hands in the backfield together frustratedly. Knows he was there. Bought a ticket to the dance.
It's good from Doak there. Talk about these box kicks, how they need to be contestable. Slightly infield, but because it was a contest, the pressure was really on Beetham.
Time is off.
Just for anyone joining the coverage, wondering why all the numbers are going red. All the way up to 26, it will be. Well, they can name 11 replacements in these under-20s games. They can only use 8 of them, though. So, 11 replacements, 8 of them can be used. We're not keeping track, but someone will be.
I mean, you see the same. Imagine being on the sideline trying to, but it's two people with clipboards, frantically Coach, flipping through them. 25 sheets of paper dawn on the floor.
Bind!
Hugh Postlethwaite is another one of those
set.
Waiting to make his mark on the game, but it's a quick ball that's come squirting out for Ford off Doak. Osborne was keen for a little offload, but sensibly was kept in. Then it's Kendall combining well 7 and 8, but that was just left forward. And can Johan Evans do any work on the floor to bring the ball back? Probably not legally. Well, he does open the palms to the skies in frustration. I think he did think he'd done enough.
He wanted the stat, didn't he? He wanted the turnover stat. Evans has been brilliant over the ball, but this is just a bit of a loose carry. Byrne not able to keep hold of it in the contact.
Crouch! Bind! Set!
In from Lloyd. All of the Welsh stacked to the left side. Lloyd picks.
Oh, play on.
Dan John had perhaps just got out of his starting blocks a little early on that run. Irish were ready to line him up. Costello! Again, it's another loss forward from Jacob Beetham, and it's not going to be doing his confidence the world of good. It's two in a row he's lost.
He has, but he had Moxon all over him. Harassing defence. Because he had to adjust the pass, it was a little bit loose. The flight of the ball not going for him, and then getting set for the collision. Moxon not hanging around.
So, Donica Byrne is going to make way. There's Daniel Akeke. Comes on. He was on the bench last week, didn't get the chance to make an impact. So,
scrum green, mark on red.
Man plays the rugby at Shannon. He's bringing his 17 stone frame onto the field for the Irish. Donica Byrne acquitted himself well. Irish back row. Such a traditional area of strength for the, as a nation. Continuing in the under 20s.
Bang!
Doak still out there doing the do along with Corkery. Nicely floated for Moxon, but it was just well spotted by Johan Evans, who has really been leading that defence. Now trying to put a little bit more width on it out the left hand side. Postlethwaite trying to use a bit of the footwork and the pace. The Ulster man who plays at Banbridge. Another one who came into the squad this week.
Thanks.
Play a bit of centre. Out on the left wing currently. And come on for Cosgrave.
Release!
Doak. Corkery. Ford. Hawkins has done well to line him up and drive him back from whence he came. Doak. Sheridan.
No hands.
Saunderson in support. Back down the short side they go. And then Illo. Get through one tackle. Get through a second. And then the drive from Soroka.
Push back, no hands!
To 10-metre gain for the Irish in the end. Oh, I think this is going to be a yellow
you're
card.
You're offside, and it's cynical, so it's a yellow.
McDonough, the try scorer, frustrated, living right on
the
edge.
Offside. He never came back, and he's putting pressure on the line.
So Wales will join
exactly
Ireland down on
14
men.
Went for the pickpocket.
Yeah, sure.
But he got caught. Never onside, absolutely correct. And then just a general pest. Whenever someone mentions they're a sprint champion, everybody wants to know their times. 14 years old, he was clocking 11.4. That's rapid.
Substitution.
Says he's much quicker now. Shame we're not going to get a chance to see him fly for the next 10 minutes.
Number two. Yeah.
Will Reid comes onto the field and looks like Sam Costello.
He's
going to conclude his evening.
Got a bit of a limp or a stone in his shoe, one of the two.
Yeah. Didn't feature last week, Will Reid, but he will make his under-20s debut as we see Mark Morrissey coming onto the field, the Leinster and UCD man. Former Leinster school's captain, no less.
Back here, 11 offside, cynical infringement.
And it's Soroka who will leave the field. Alex Soroka. Another decent performance by him, wasn't it?
There's a grafter. Another big rep, contact man. Puts a shift in. I like to see that. And when you've got the ability to play back row, second row, you're always going to be one of those workhorses.
How many players coming in? Six. How many players? Six? Who's the receiver?
Irish line out. Plenty of new faces on the field now.
Who's the receiver on your side? 2 meters.
Saunderson, Illo,
okay, thank
Morrissey.
You. Play on.
Akeke as well. It's going to go up to one of the men who's been on all evening so far. Sheridan brings it down. Line-out caller. And now they twist towards the corner. And Ireland are over. It's the fourth try and the bonus point for the men in green. And is it George Saunderson? I think it might be. It's a Keke.
And he is made up, isn't he? Big smiles. Something they practice often. Messed around the numbers all game, Irish, because of the shortened version. Get the turn at the front, and then there's no stopping him. Way ahead of the five Welsh defenders, trying to push it toward the touchline. And Okeke is beaming. David Nussafora, bottom of shot there. He's had an interesting week out in Monaco, watching the Irish Sevens win their place at the Olympics. Not a bad week.
Did you see him on the sunbeds, did you?
Certainly didn't see him in the hairdressers. You wonder how crucial these bonus points will be.
Wait,
it's just a consummate Irish performance. Still 10 minutes to really grind this game down as well.
Wales 12, Ireland 33. Back from forward.
Stop, Green! Stop!
It's a really solid clearance. Basics have been done so well.
Line for the Green?
Haven't they?
Green?
Richie Murphy's team have
line is yours.
Looked very composed.
And they kept it simple. You know, it's not the most extravagant game plan. They run hard off nine. They can play off ten with a little bit more width. But it's about their ability to get back down the field. That's been the point of difference. Good box kicking. You say how good Doak's been guiding them at that area.
Move!
Chinza brings it down.
That's once.
Lloyd. Got to try and send Hawkins straight over the line.
Yeah, I got it.
And a good low carry from Lewis Jones, replacement prop who's onto the field.
The advantage for offside green.
His debut last week, but now Chinza, this is what he can do. Energy and carries.
The advantage for offside.
Oh, Reid, I thought for a moment that was going to be intercepted.
Push back green.
Beat them, did well to hold on to it. Burrows, the dummy and the carry. This is better from Wales now. Tui Palotu, a little bit of footwork, gets round the first defender. Reid. Having a little look at the options, doesn't want to get isolated. Round the corner come Wales, it just stopped momentarily, didn't
new
it?
New advantage, Tuckwell not turning away.
Tui Palotu offering himself. Gets the call on the outside from Reid, it's passed on, but...
Back here, number
there
six.
An advantage being played.
Number eight, sorry.
You're against Kendallan in an offside position.
And their line speed, that served them well. A little bit too quick out the blocks. And then when the tackle was made, not getting out the way of it. Referee's been very, very clear on this all game, hasn't he? You've got to get out the way, especially if it's got momentum in the play. Just roll as quick as you can.
Just block the...
Just overheard an Irish voice on the referee's mic, I think it was, just saying, don't let them in.
Green, set the gap, please. The gap. Time is back on. Move!
Ball is brought down.
Stay bound. Now away. Here.
Wales building the momentum towards the line as they go in search of try number three. Could be room left in the game for them to go for the bonus point in this one.
On the line.
There's probably not enough time for them to turn the result round. Just short once more.
Advantage seven offside.
And now an advantage being played against McCormack. Three of them on the drive.
Release,
being brilliantly held up by Saunderson for a moment. He's got to release it.
Back here.
And come back for the penalty.
I think he's going to have the conversation now.
I can award the try because you're tackled, and in the second you score. In the second time you score. This is why I can award the try. Just here.
Much better discipline from both sides, actually, the second half. Got to recognise that.
Time off. 14.
Another change for the Irish. Oh, Ben Moxon.
I don't know.
Grown into the game.
Oh, wait.
Leaves the field, replaced by Conor Rankin. The Welsh try and do it again.
Play advantage.
They've lost 5 metres from the line-out position already. Oh. Ball's been knocked forwards. I think that was the call from the referee. Ireland will have the scrum, and well, the celebrations tell you everything.
Big celebrations. Back slaps, jet slaps all around. They are a strange breed, forwards, aren't they? But they love it. Wouldn't cheer that loud if you had an 80-metre wonder try, would they? But because they practice this day in, day out, get amongst it, try and push it back. You can see them trying to fragment the driving more going forward from the Welsh. They do exactly that because they start going backwards. Players panic, hands go in the wrong place, the ball gets knocked on.
Yeah, because you were tackled, and in the second movement, you scored.
Ollie Burrows just having a little chat with our referee.
So you need a pen and paper when you're chatting to the referee.
Keep it close, I am. I understand. We wait for the prop. Keep breathing.
Referee reminding everyone to keep breathing there. It's full of handy advice.
Mark is here. And time's back on.
Second!
Crouch! Bind! Set!
Pick from Kandela and into the open side, having a dope pull off
it's on the
to
tackle.
The blind side.
Stop, Green! Stop!
A little bit of a slice on the clearance. Wales will have the line out.
And that's where the drills really do
13.
Show how much they practice, because the space was in front, didn't need to go back for the clearance kick. Dope could have took that on his right. Wonderful carry to get him there from Kendallin. And that's a good shift from the Welsh centre.
Move! He's through the middle, play on.
Oh, Tua Pilotti's done well. Lloyd, counter-ruck from the Irish, is not giving the Welsh any time on the ball, and they will win themselves the penalty.
18.
Extraordinary energy and desire from the team comfortably in front.
And that's why they got the favourites tag. The Irish really are taking it to the Welsh in every aspect of this game. And so much in these games, it comes down to that emotional, psychological effort. You just feel they've got a bit more control.
That's well kept in field. John.
Push back, Green! Green, push back! Push back!
Lloyd. Terry Pilotti. Reed. Oh, it wasn't an easy one. Ireland following up with Ford. Ford is coming back.
All right, 8.
Reed inside his 22.
Stop, Red! Stop.
Not quite sure where that kick was aimed for. It's going to bounce its way into touch.
But again, typical. 75th minute. And the pressure on the kicker from the Irish players flying through is significant enough to make a real difference.
Green, please.
The Irish forwards just taking their time to work out their next line-out plan. Playing around with numbers all game, favouring The 5 plus 2, it seems. The sixth man joining the line late.
Yes, he did it!
Pops up for De Butler. Onto the field for the Irish, number 16. Ford trying to tidy things up. Doak Sheridan around the corner. He's worked his absolute socks off.
He has no incidents. You can play.
And
you
for
can
De
play.
Butler. Chinza making the tackle. Ford. It's a good take. Ben Carson with the little juggle of the ball. Candelum. Eight on
run
eight
away,
tackle once more from Tuipulotu.
Play advantage. Number eight not running away.
Tuipulotu hasn't worked hard enough after the tackle. There's the advantage now being played to the
advantage
Irish. Jude
penalty.
Postlethwaite having to try and swim his way past the tackles. It's loose.
Back here, number eight, you're not running away.
It's been a great battle with those two, hasn't it? Both eights, Kendlin and Tuipulotu. Got a feeling they're going to have a few battles over the next 10 years or so. Potentially in green and red.
Okay, thanks. You're welcome.
Two minutes remaining in the match then. And that man there has had a pretty impressive game so far. He's still keeping Ireland in the right areas of the field. De Butler for Sheridan.
Move!
Working his role at the line out. He's also carried 45 metres in the game, Sheridan. And here come the Irish. They're looking to get over for a fifth try.
Release red! Release red!
They're that close. Burrowing down the short side. Candelan over the top. And it'll be the cherry on the cake for the Irish skipper. Ireland scoring 5 tries. And the chance to bring up 40 points with a conversion.
You can't mention Doak's influence in this game without also mentioning Candelan. Been absolutely everywhere. 18 carries, of which 79 metres have been made, but 14 tackles as well. This guy's got a burning bright future. And what an education he must have had in the ranks at Munster. And there's every single ounce of him to suggest he's on the next conveyor belt in this wonderful production of Irish number eights.
Conversion. It brings up 40 points. It brings up 20 points for himself. Wales 12, Ireland 40.
And he is absolutely loving it. Two right here is player of the match. Nathan Doak, wonderful all-round game for this Irish 20s team. He has led them admirably.
And the man whose name flashes up as player of the match will complete the last act, clear behind the posts. It was a superb performance from the Irish scrum half. Five tries in the end from Ireland then. Wales able to reply with scores from Alex Mann and McDonough. But the job has been done by the side who are looking every bit the favourites for the 2021 Under-20 Six Nations Championship. The round two match has finished Wales 12, Ireland 40. It's been a solid performance, Rob Vickerman.
Yeah, absolutely. I think the game was actually done at half-time. A 17-0 lead. That increased to a 22 points to nothing lead for the Irish, and there wasn't really much hope of the Welsh getting back into it, the strength and dominance of this Irish team will make the rest of the teams quite scared.
Notable performances, as we said, from the Irish back row, but that man, Kyle Ford, as well, with 12 on his back, working with Jennings in that midfield. Housemates, the pair of them, as I think we mentioned at the start. Just finished his first year in the Connacht Academy. Just been real calmness and confidence in that area of the field for the Irish over the course of the full 80.
It really has been. And when you have a centre partnership that can go forward and well-versed in playing together, it gives you so much foundations in a game. And when you change the 9 and 10, you know there's going to be difficulties in their ability to pull the strings and get them in the right places and perhaps execute their own game with the pressures on. But that comfort from the centres, friends, housemates, as you say, wonderful performers. And a nice mix as well. Big back line, this Irish team, and you felt that that was always going to give them that physical edge. You can see here, just by the shots, how big these guys are. And it does account for a lot. And a fast pitch, you know, you're guaranteed that pace on the ball. And the Irish really did well at a counter at times in this game.
How much of it would you say is the dominance of the Irish? How much of Wales' inability to quite get going in that first half was their own undoing, or what Ireland were doing?
Well, pretty amazing to think that Wales came in this with an unchanged 15, so they had plenty more time together to combine those minutes. You'd think they would settle into it a bit more, but as everything seemed to be around how the Welsh exited their own territory, that was what it's about. First start of the game.
Congratulations, Alex. Can I ask you to present Nathan with his Man of the Match medal? Well, congratulations on the win, a bonus point win, and it seemed pretty comfortable by the end.
Yeah, I know, look, the boys dug deep. It's never easy coming to Wales and beating them in their backyard, but all credit to the lads, like, we fought right through the end there, and Wales were physical and stuff, but honestly, we've worked hard, and we knew they were going to bring it to us tonight, so we're happy to deliver a win.
And on a personal note, nice to have that medal in your hand, and nice to get on the score sheet as well.
Yeah, I don't usually score too many, so it's nice to get over the try line, but yeah, we're just happy for the win, and go enjoy it now with the lads, and we'll focus for England next week.
Yeah, how much confidence have you got going into that game? Because it is a mouth-watering encounter now.
Yeah, definitely. Like, we've looked at England and we know the threats that they bring, but we fully back ourselves to do the job on them, and we'll be going in there with great confidence and our belief to produce the performance we produced tonight.
Yeah, what about your record in this competition? A 10th consecutive win and also reigning champions. You seem to be flying high at the moment.
Yeah, look, it's credit to everyone involved in the RFU, top to bottom. Like, the guys that came before us set that platform, and everyone just wants to live up to their expectations, and everyone wants to get their hands on that trophy, so we're just trying to compete like with everyone else and try to win the thing at the end of it. Like.
Well, congratulations. Thanks very much.
Cheers, thank you.
Alex, congratulations. Sum that one up for us, because it seemed very clinical from an Irish point of view.
Oh, look, it's not easy coming over here to Wales and beating them in their backyard. And look, it was massive from the boys today. We knew how physical they were going to be, and they didn't let us down, really. They put it up to us from minute one, and look, I'm super proud of the boys, and yeah, look, we're moving on to England now and hopefully get the win there as well.
You seem to be really clicking as a side, and as the competition progresses, maybe even growing in confidence?
Yeah, look, it's all credit to Richie, Leams and Cully. They've really brought us together as one. They're building something nice in here, and it's a pleasure to be a part of.
You mentioned England up next. Is that where this tournament is won or lost?
Look, We'll take the day off tomorrow. We'll look at that performance. We'll come back to it. We'll analyse England and we'll go from there. They're going to be a completely different beast. We know that physically and the backs wise we saw today, them playing. But look, it's what we look forward to.
How are you dealing with this bubble? Is it easier in a way to be sort of on your own, isolated, and just concentrating on the job in hand?
Exactly. We're all in as one. We're basically brothers at this stage. We're bonding extremely well, and I said, it's all credit to Richie Leams and Collie, what they're doing with us. They can take massive credit from that.
Well, we're looking forward to next week already. Thank you very much.
Thanks,
congratulations.
Guys. Thank you.
Hi Alex, how are you? We won't keep you long. Alex, sum that one up for us. A real tough encounter, but I guess that's what you were expecting from Ireland.
Yeah, it's international rugby at the end of the day. We knew it was going to be tough, we said that in a week. Just coming from the Adler, we were all disappointed because we're like one big family there. But we, like you said, we got to bounce back. That's what great teams do, we bounce back. And we look forward to the next game, we just learn from it. All credit to Ireland, but we know we could be better there.
Yeah, what was the difference? Was it just maybe the small mistakes, especially in that first half?
Yes, yeah, like I said, it's international rugby. The small mistakes, they were clinical on us, so it's kept building the score. So that's where the disappointment comes. But like I said, we're looking forward to the next one now. Heads up, we'll recover well and we'll go again.
What about the character, though, especially to get those tries, one for yourself, in that second half?
Yeah, the boys showed really good character, to be fair. Like from the last game, we all work for each other, really want to work for each other. That's where the disappointment comes, because we all want to do well. But like I said, we learn from it. That's how we get better as a team.
France had a very close game against Italy earlier on today. What are you expecting from them?
Same as the other team, physicality, but we know we're going to We can't wait to meet their head on, to be fair.
And what does next week look like for you now? You're obviously in this bubble. How does it pan out?
Rest and recover. Because, like I said, we are a tight-knit group, so we enjoy each other's company. But I know it's going to be that bitter edge to it now because we lost, and we always want to get better as a team. And we've got the talent there, so just look over our game, how to get better. And like we said, we're ready for the French.
Best of luck with that one. Thanks
very
Alex.
Much. I appreciate
your time.
Thank you.
Well, for you. Not tonight. No. I got some polyfill. Yeah. How are you? I've got. This is a woolen coat, but I've just been sat. It's.